The Philippine government wants Kadiwa stores to be a permanent fixture in markets nationwide. A Kadiwa store is a government-organized pop-up shop that sells goods at cheaper prices. The commodities there are more affordable since they are sold by small businesses and cooperatives. President Marcos on Wednesday said his administration is looking to create a system where goods do not have to pass through middlemen to reduce pass-on charges to consumers. Agriculture Assistant Secretary Christine Evangelista says they are working on accrediting Kadiwa retailers in wet markets.
The Philippine Coast Guard defends its move, exposing China's bullying in the West Philippine Sea, saying it is the best way to address Chinese aggressions. Our correspondent Willard Chang on the line with that story. Willard.
Hi, Ron. Commodore J. Tariel of the Philippine Coast Guard stressed the importance of exposing incidents of what he described as Chinese bullying in the West Philippine Sea, saying it is the best way to address and counter Chinese gray zone tactics. Speaking to reporters on the sidelines of a forum organized by the Strat-based ADR Institute and the Konrad Adenauer Stiftung, Ariela said the Philippine Coast Guard's release of information regarding the Chinese Coast Guard's use of military-grade laser against the PCG last month was effective in eliciting a reaction from China through press conferences and support from other countries for the Philippines. In his remarks, that he said that he is delivering as a maritime security scholar and not as representative of government, Tariela said Chinese actions in the shadows are now checked by making these public.
Ito ang example natin, no, na we can notice itong pag-response ng China every time we publicize itong mga events. Secondly, how are we going to measure also the impact of publishing all these incidents? We can see it from how the United States, Japan, Australia expressed their support and also their willingness to develop the capability of the Philippine Coast Guard and also the armed forces of the Philippines.
The Philippine Coast Guard's role now of becoming a mouthpiece of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea allows the like-minded states to express condemnation and reproach, which puts Beijing into spotlight. Chinese actions in the shadows are now checked, which also forced them to come out in the open to explain or to publicly lie. This behavior can be seen when the pointing of the military-grade laser incident was publicized.
Tariela said China has achieved fait accompli, having occupied Mischief Reef in 1995, started their 9 dash line presence in 2005, taken over Scarborough Shoal in 2012, and reclaimed various maritime features in 2013 without firing a single shot or resorting to military action. He said the Philippine Coast Guard started to assume a frontline role in patrolling the waters in the South China Sea following that 2012 standoff in Scarborough Shoal, and with ASEAN not supporting the deployment of military-grade ships in the waters of the South China Sea. He added, former President Duterte also used the Coast Guard for appeasement strategy towards China, since the use of white ships in patrolling the waters did not supposedly appear to be provocative.
Learning from the 2012 Scarborough Shoal standoff, former President Benigno Aquino began to utilize Coast Guard as part of his white ship strategy in the West Philippine Sea. Since China criticized him for militarizing the maritime dispute in 2012, Aquino turned to relying on Coast Guard vessels to maintain the Philippine presence in the West Philippine Sea. However, in the case of President Rodrigo Duterte, the Philippine Coast Guard was widely utilized for appeasement strategy towards China, since the utilization of white ships in patrolling the contested waters does not appear to be provocative.
In the end, Tariela pushed for 3 policy recommendations: that the national government support the modernization of the PCG to allow it to increase its ability to monitor gray zone activities, pointing out that there are already reports of incursions of the country's northern territory and the eastern seaboard, particularly Benham Rise. He also advocated for keeping the PCG as the option to patrol the West Philippine Sea as supported by the Philippine Navy, and to continue to expose Chinese gray zone activities. Ron, back to you.
Willard Chang with that report. Thanks, Willard.